All right, I am here with Julianne Kost, who is Adobe's principal evangelist. So everybody should know who she is. If you do not, go to her website at least. What's the Photoshop one? I mean, obviously there's jkost.net for your
That's
your
just
art.
Personal, yeah, work. Yeah. But all my Photoshop and Lightroom tutorials and tricks and tips are on blogs.adobe.com/jkost, which is J-K-O-S-T.
Perfect, that's it, yes. So one of the things I like about Julianne is, I didn't prep you for this, so
no.
But you are amazingly technical, but your images have like a lot of heart and emotion, and you got the creative side nailed. And I feel like that's one of the biggest things that people don't get, photographers-wise. There's always one side or the other, and I feel like there's those few like geniuses that are right in the middle, so...
I'm very fortunate just in the house that I grew up in with my mom and my dad, so both of them very technical and creative, and whether it was my mom doing painting and silk screening or my dad doing his darkroom work, because he was a like amateur photographer, we had a darkroom, of course, in the laundry room. What I learned from them was that in order to have a better chance of making a successful image,
yeah,
I needed to learn the technical,
yeah,
so that I would know how to get it, but then you also have to kind of let go and explore that,
yeah,
creative side.
Amazing.
Yeah.
Yeah. And I have your first book, Window Seat.
Yep.
Well, it was Images from a Plane, which has inspired me to take a lot of iPhone pictures from planes.
Good.
Yeah. And she just came out with a new book, which is available on Amazon, called Passenger Seat, which everybody has to buy.
Oh, okay. That would be great.
Amazing. Amazing images.
Really fun project. So the book talks a lot about personal projects and why we do them and how we select them and how you actually finish them, right? Because
yeah,
we all start them, but how do you actually come up with a game plan to really see it to fruition? So whether that's a gallery show or self-publishing or just even putting, you know, images on a website, it's how to kind of make that project come true. And I used a personal project of my own as the example, and
yeah,
the back of it is all the Lightroom to Photoshop workflow.
So it's not, yeah, it's not just an art book of
no,
really awesome, emotional, abstract images.
Thank you.
But how to.
Yep.
Which is, okay. So, all right. So the big question I'm asking everybody is, what's one thing you think photographers need or could work on? If you can narrow down the one thing this year, and it could be really, almost anything, whatever you think.
To work on, well, I think it'll really help to keep an open mind, because as always, you know, technology is constantly changing. For me personally, because I do spend so much time in front of the computer, I'm just a huge advocate of reading. So whether your goal is, you know, you have to decide for yourself whether it's one book a month or one book a week, I would just highly recommend that we kind of get back to reading, because reading, instead of just consuming someone else's interpretation of words, when you read, you actually have to build that into your own imagination. And so
yeah,
for me, I think it can stretch us and make us think about things and imagine things that otherwise we might not.
Michael Medved, who I'm a big fan of, has a stat that he quotes a lot about how the average American, this is from the 90s, so I'm probably different now, but the average American watches more TV than they do work hours in the day. And if you add it up, no sleep, no eating, it's about 13 continuous hours of their life watching TV. Compared to most successful people read quite a bit of books.
You know,
so
I can't imagine what that would be today if you also include like just browsing on social media,
yeah,
sites and consuming YouTube content. And,
yeah.
I mean, that's the
dumbing
great thing
down
about
America.
Well, that's the great thing about being a photographer, right, is that we can turn that around and say, no, I don't want to just consume content. I want to create content.
Yeah.
And get out there and tell our stories.
Awesome. Okay. Well, thank you so much.
You're welcome. Thank you, Brian.